Quiet weather day outside, but thundering action inside Wells Fargo for the state 1A women's basketball quarterfinals. Top-rated Martinsdale St. Mary taking on Newell Fonda. First half action here. Newell Fonda's Renee Manaman. She hesitates and up and over. A little hurricane move there for two. Martinsdale St. Mary starts to pull away. Sam Norris pushing it across the court. Up and in for the lay-in. Now down low, Mackenzie Morrison. Little block. Off the shot, rebounds, scores. A lot of experience shown. Martinsdale St. Mary's 47-34.
This was a little bit different tempo than what we had seen for a large part of the year, and the girls did a really good job adjusting as we go along. They've kind of been a third quarter team all year as far as adjusting and picking it up when they need to. We have a lot of seniors, so that helps a lot too.
Other 1A action, the pride of Taylor County. Mount Air Bedford not having a good day. They're falling to West Hancock, 67-59. Best pheasant hunting in Iowa is found near Arcadia, Westside, and Vail. Some good basketball there, too. Arweva, Linville, Sully. That was on purpose. Linville, Sully striking early. Brianna James in the paint. She connects. The Rockets. Caitlin Ertz says, we haven't been to state in 20 years, and we're not going home empty-handed. Ertz again. The Rockets, 40 second half points, easily sinking Linville, Sully, 60-38. Now North Mahaska against Bellevue Marquette. North Mahaska's Kate Ray from three. Not bad. Down to the final seconds. Mallory Boyle gets three with the Warhawks within three. 3 seconds left now. Come on, 3 seconds left. There we go. Could it be? It's up. Oh, and she'll be remembering that one for just a little while. All right, let's move on to 2A action this evening. Monticello moving the ball, looking for the perfect shot. We take you now to Paxton Killier. She hits the layup, but Mount Air comes right back. Becca Pennington. She's up and under, gets the foul and the shot. And right before the end of the first quarter, Pennington connects on the layup. Listen for the buzzer. There it is. All right, in the old days, it was the Manning Bulldogs. Well, they're now the IKM Manning Wolves against Otobolt Arthur, Bravo Charlie India Golf. We pick up things in the second half. IKM Manning fought back from 16 down. Kaylee Blake here on the layup cuts the Otobolt Arthur, we'll just call him Ida Grove, lead to two, but it was just too much Falcons. Jessie Polly on the drive. She hits the pull-up jumper. No. Anyway, the Falcons advancing to the Class 2A semis with a 54-50 victory. All right, move on just a bit. West Fork against Roland Story tomorrow for the 2A. That's 10 a.m. Pella Christian against Esterville, Lincoln Center. That's at 11:45. 3A action tomorrow. Sergeant Bluff against Davenport Assumption and South Tama taking on Ballard. All right, congratulations. Oh, one more. Here we go. Central DeWitt, MOC Floyd Valley. Benton Community, Mount Vernon, that's at 8:30. Now, we'll move on to the Simpson women. Congratulations to them advancing to the NCAA Division III tournament with an at-large berth. It's the seventh straight season, and it makes 11 trips in the program history. They're going to face Concordia Moorhead. Moorhead, Duane's Pizza, some of the best pizza in the Northern Plains. All right, tournament time also means practice underway for arena football, but it's not at Veterans Auditorium. Well, time to see how difficult the sportscasting world is. We're at the Jacobson Building at the fairgrounds, and you think, why are we here if we're talking Barnstormers football? Well, this is where they're practicing while Vets is being renovated, and head coach and operations manager John Gregory is here, and a lot of excitement this year. I've heard a lot of talk about Brad Banks. That's got to get the Hawkeye folks kind of fired up.
Well, Brad's in here, and he's competing for a quarterback spot. We have great competition at that spot, so it'll be interesting to see who comes out ahead.
I'm an Iowa State person, and I heard that Brett Crevet is playing here. That's got to add a new element to the D-line.
Well, Brett's one of the real class players. He's been a great player for us the last 3 years, and he'll be one of our leaders on defense.
Okay, sounds good. And exposure-wise, good attendance last year, had some near-record numbers, and back on the NFL Network again. Is that correct?
Well, those are all great things. We're always right at the top of the league attendance-wise. Our fans have a great time at the game, and we're looking forward to that. The players already been talking about that. New guys in, other players are saying, hey, this is the best place to play right here. So that's great.
All right. Congratulations on what appears to be a great season shaping up. March 19th, they kick off, and the first home game is March 25th against Spokane. Now, typically the start of arena football coincides with the start of severe weather in Iowa. So tonight, I want to unveil our new fleet of storm chasers. They're obviously well-equipped, and they're ready for the season ahead. It's just part of my commitment to keeping you, the viewer, especially those who vote at KCCI.com, ahead of the storm. Wave goodbye,
nice
ladies.
Nice job, John. Nice job. How very nice,
that?
John. Love it. Okay, Andy. Can you rate John on 1 to 10?
Sorry, I'm voting for myself here on KCCI.com. Sorry.
Not yet.
Well, you know, I didn't have a group helping me out. That was just me by myself. But, John, excellent job. I'd give you 8.5 out of 10. A little room for improvement, but very solid. Presentation, 11.
Okay, great.
Top
thank
show.
You.
Ladies,
yeah.
Thank you very
John,
much.
I think
well
he's
done.
Jealous that he had a cute puppy, but you've got gorgeous girls. So, yeah, he's a little jealous.
Umbrella protection.
There you go, John.